Hey guys, just give me one second here. If you're talking, I won't see the chat just yet. Just give me one second here. Got a bit distracted with something right at the very end there. Where am I here? Where's Twitch? There's Twitch. Chat is loading as far as I can tell. I think I'm in the chat now. Cool. I also need to post my ad on Instagram. Getting a look behind the awkward curtain tonight, folks. Phone to do the thing it's supposed to be doing here. There we go. Okay. We are in. Hey, Michelle. How are you doing? One sec. Just gonna check one more thing really quick here. All right, we're officially good to go. How you doing, Michelle? Also, guys, my new pencil arrived. Literally haven't even opened it yet. I'm gonna do that right now. Hey, Billy. General Kenobi. Hello there. Be excited for the new pencil, guys. I'm excited for the new pencil. I actually found another pencil that I had discarded. And that one was working slightly better, but still had some issues. So I'm excited to have the new one. Came with two packs of lead, but I got extra as well. Shouldn't need to bust into that today, though, assuming this is working. I'm not too bad, Michelle. New pencil, yay! Working overtime, but I assume you're still at home, right, Michelle? Look at this new eraser that I'm forbidden to ever use, because as soon as you use it, it pops it. Is my hand in focus? I think it's in focus, right? Okay, I guess it is. It feels darker than normal. That's weird. Actually, you know what, there's already some lead in here, so I'm actually, hang on, I'm going to transplant the lead from the old pencil, and then we'll get started. This arrived today, by the way, and because the other one's eaten through lead so crazy, I was worried I wasn't going to have lead for today. I would have had to go old school, use a different kind of pencil or something. Okay, I will save this one as a backup. I can't. Are you being sarcastic, Billy, or is it actually not in focus? Because how can you tell if it's in focus? All right. There's nothing on the paper, though. What are you talking about? You mean sitting on the paper? It's not. What the hell? Okay, hang on. All right, one sec. I'll see if I can fix that. Oh, yeah, you're right. Okay, one sec. Hey, Mark. There we go. I don't normally have to mess with the focus. I always turn autofocus off. Maybe something was weird. Okay. Now we're good, I think. All right. Here we go. Moment of truth. Oh, that was so satisfying. You have no idea. Okay. We're drawing Kali. This is for this month's character design challenge. The theme was to do Indian gods, or maybe it was specifically Hindu gods. I don't remember. It was a toss up between Ganesh and Kali, and I was tempted to do Ganesh because it's the elephant head. I thought would be kind of interesting, but that was what they used for their promo, and I felt like a lot of people were going to do that, so I decided to go with Kali. Because she seems cool. Scary, but cool. So I got some vague-ish ideas. Probably not going to go too outside the box on this one. Been pretty distracted with stuff, so I didn't like... I watched a 15-minute video about her earlier. And I grabbed some reference images. That's about it. What do you mean, Billy? Oh, shit. doing the setup stuff? Oh, right, gotcha. Thing I meant to look up and I never did was I was considering looking up like Indian dance poses or something, see if I would inspire a specific pose, but I forgot and I'm not gonna bother now. Kind of an idea of where I'm going with this anyway. I don't know if I can properly express my excitement over this new pencil. If I'm being totally honest, guys, like, you have no idea. not too bad. I have three classes in person now. And it's good to be back. It's weird with the mask thing, because... I mean, I'm not an anti-masker, obviously. I'm all for wearing the mask. But I'm used to only having to wear them, like, to go in and out of a store or something. I'm not used to having to wear it, like, all day. And by the end of the day, I'm like very excited to get that thing turned off or taken off. Hey, Chantel. I can understand the excitement over a freezer. I keep checking to see if it's still okay. The other one was doing me wrong a bit too long. Okay, you know what? I don't like this post. I looked at one of my reference images that is only there for costume purposes, and I like that pose better. I'm gonna do that one. I'm also worried that this raised knee is gonna get in the way of what I want to do with the arms. So let's, you can salvage the top half though. That's good. Pull exaggerator a bit more over this way though. I'm liking this pose. Yeah, we kind of went back to that recently as well. And I mean, like, I'd rather do that than the alternative. Like, I'm not really complaining, but it's definitely a weird thing. And it's only I'm only at the school 2 days a week typically, so that will probably make the getting used to it a little bit slower as well, I imagine. I mean, I would wear them to the grocery store and stuff, and that was pretty much it for the most part. I think what was happening with the old pencil is it was somehow, I'm not entirely sure how or why, but it was being like really rough with the lead as it pulled it through, so it would crack midway and then become too loose. I was in a store today and there was this guy It's a really loudmouth guy, would not stop complaining about the passport thing to prove that you've been vaccinated. Are you guys getting that in Saskatchewan? Chantel? Hey, Mars. Yes, she is. Although, this is kind of awkward. I watched the whole thing on it earlier. Remind me what she... oh, here we go. Kali, also known as Kalika, is the chief of the Mahavidyas, a group of 10 Trantic gods who each form a different aspect of the mother goddess Parvati. Or Parvati. So time, creation, destruction, and power. Wow, Shinta. Oops. Yes. Evidently, they did. She's sometimes depicted with only four arms and sometimes six. Or eight. Or maybe even more. I'm giving her all eight. Mars. I did. Actually, the first character design challenge I ever did was actually a Aztec warrior. But wasn't... they're crazy about how that one turned out, actually. I've mentioned the show a couple times on the stream, I think. Hysteria. I remember learning a bunch about some Aztec stuff in that, and it got pretty gruesome at times. I think we got our basic shape here. I'll let you know though that one Aztec goddess is actually going to appear in a future combat fairy story. So I actually have done a little bit of reading. I don't remember what that goddess's name was exactly, though, because it's like 17 letters long, but, you know. You think you know which one I was talking about? I think you... No. Are you saying that because of the long name, or was there some other clue that made you think... Oh, no. She's not like a main character. She's somebody that they're going to encounter. No. I mean, I can tell you what she's the goddess of, if that helps. there. Actually, Billy just got it. Goddess of water. Yeah, they call her Chalchi as a nickname in the comic. Sensei Nakachikantupa. Cool can. Yeah. Still not the easiest though. So Kali typically has like a necklace of heads or skulls. But in the interest of mixing things up, I didn't want to lose that because it's such a distinctive trait of hers, but in the interest of mixing things up a bit, I'm going to put them around her belt instead. Yeah, I'm undecided about the dress of arms. Such a fluffy goddess? Why do you say that? That grew multiple heads? Maybe in what mythology? You know what? I'm gonna get rid of this cloth. I'm gonna use the jewelry as her covering. I would have considered just having her full on topless, to be honest, because that's how she's often depicted as well. But I don't know how the characters on Challenge feels about that. And I know that it would run the risk of being taken down off of wherever I might post it. Oh. Then maybe I'm not clear on what you meant by fluffy at all then, Chantal. If I didn't even get that, it was sarcasm. Oh. Oh wait, the no nipples means fluffy, or you mean, or are you talking about something? I'm so confused. I'm so lost. I know Facebook isn't like nipples, so I assume that's what you're referring to. Oh, okay, gotcha. Also, there was a Rambo cartoon in the 80s where he was always nippleless. Did He-Man have nipples? I don't think he did. In the original He-Man, I mean. By the way, did I tell you guys I watched that? The Masters of the Universe, finally? I liked it. It was good. Yeah, exactly, Merce. You know, I think, like, with all the fan complaints, though, about it, and, like, it's mostly just sexist assholes and stuff, but I think that what part of the issue I think they had there is, like, I think if they had marketed it more as, like, kind of like a Return to Oz type of thing, where we're kind of catching up with, because it's, like, the first episode is, could arguably be set immediately after the original show. Not that I remember what the last episode was. It was, like, I think I was, like, 6 months old when the last episode originally aired, but, like, they marketed it off of nostalgia, so I think everybody was expecting the same thing, but I think that treating it the way they did, I think, might have even, the people that were put off by it might have actually been okay with it if that's what they knew they were getting. Some of them are just douchebags. They're like, no, a woman can't lead this, but, I think some of them were just kind of like, they thought they were getting something else. That makes sense. That's a surprise. Masters of the Universe, Mars. Neil Adams, comic book artist that did a fairly famous run of Batman in the 70s. He's the one that I think first designed Ra's al Ghul, or Ra's al Ghul, however the hell you pronounce it. And he drew Batman with a shirt off and drew hair on his chest. And that was apparently like a big thing. That was like an earth shattering, like, what? Hair on Batman's chest? Have you lost your mind? I actually remember in when I was a kid watching the Superman animated series. And noticing that they did actually give Superman nipples when he had his shirt off. And I think the fact that that actually got my attention is probably because I was so used to them not doing that on TV shows. Okay, let's start inking her. I watched the 2D one. Is the 3D one out yet? I knew they were doing it. I didn't know it was out yet. I actually did pencil in irises, but I think I'm gonna keep them out. I'm gonna make her irisless, pupilless. Unless, of course, I forget my own plan and accidentally put them in which case I'm committed. Okay. I thought it was weird that they were doing two different versions of Masters of the Universe at the same time. What is the young blood disease? The no pupils. And if that is what you're referring to, is that related to Youngblood the comic? Yeah, there's like a more like, there's a 3D version of it that is meant more for a younger audience, and it's a bit more of like a modernized version of the original by the looks of it. I haven't seen a trailer, I've only seen stills from it, and I haven't even seen many of those, but it must have only just dropped recently, because it wasn't that long ago that I initially saw a thing about it, and it said it was coming, so... Okay. I know the comic you mean. It was Rob Liefeld's comic. Liefeld, who's also famous for not drawing feet too often. And he co-created Deadpool, and Deadpool actually makes a joke about not being able to draw feet in Deadpool 2. When he's making fun of Domino's powers. Yeah, it's weird. And apparently, there's a live-action She-Ra series being developed at Amazon now. Which makes me wonder if the rights that Netflix had have already lapsed, because I would assume that would include live-action and animation. But maybe they lapsed super fast and they can't do any new ones anymore. I can't quite read that. Is that Brad? Is that BC Bot Killer following us? Is that what that notification said, guys? It says I have a new follower over there, but it's not showing me here. Oh, wait. That's weird. Jeff the Baby Landshark. Well, thank you, Jeff the Baby Landshark. And Kyle Roll. Thanks, guys. I don't know why it's not showing up on my screen here. I agree, Mars. You need to embrace animation a lot more often for some of this stuff. Yeah, Winx Club, I watched the first half of that first episode. I was not too into that. Which suits Mars? You mean Masters of the Universe? They actually did do a live-action Masters of the Universe back in the 80s. And they've been talking about doing another one. Yeah, it was a very far cry from the actual thing. I loved it as a kid, and I think I'd get a kick out of it for nostalgia, but it's not known for being a great movie. Actually, I feel like He-Man himself would be a tough one just because the loincloth is a bit hard to not make look ridiculous. But a lot of those costumes, I mean, think about, like, Thor and stuff. Managed to make it work. But you're gonna go that realistic. Asgard's not that realistic. Drawing feels very delicate to me. You have these ones where it's like so many curved lines and she's not wearing a lot of gear and stuff to kind of break things up. I just remembered I meant to add some. I'm not gonna do this to all of her arms, but I did want to add. Oh yeah, well, with good cause, because they already tried it once and that didn't go too well. Synopsis sound like drastically different from the original. Yeah, it threw me off. Also, I should say, so I don't come off like a poser, I actually still haven't watched the original Avatar. It's been on my list forever. I know I need to do it. Yeah, when they first announced that they were doing this new one, I think the thing that gave everybody hope was the fact that the original creators were involved. And then they left over creative differences. And it's like, what creative differences could you possibly have that would make the people that clearly know the property better than anybody leave? Exactly, Chantal. Dante Basco? I'm not sure who that is. Actually, no, never mind. I was going to say something, but you basically already said it, Chantal. Well, that's cool. Sorry if I'm blocking the camera here, guys. This will just take me a second. Just doing some tiny shit here. Chantel does like her fanfiction. A new film? Like animated? They're doing a live action film at the same time as the new animated series, and they're getting ahead of themselves. But they're doing like an animated movie that's continuing from the show. And that's cool. That was yes to the animated thing. Comment. Yeah, it's just that they aren't they doing like four seasons all at once or something like that? And they're spending like $17 billion or some shit. Okay. Definitely want to get caught up on Avatar. I'm going to try to do that relatively soon. Which, unfortunately, would not be the first time I've said that, but I mean it this time, damn it. that and Rebels. I think it's a combination of things. I think there might be drawing from the Silmarillion. I think it might be an original story. I'm not sure. Only time will tell if it'll be worth it. I feel like on a purely financial level, though, it's almost foolproof. But it's hard to say. Well, then again, I don't know, because if they're committed to multiple seasons, people are going to tune in for that first season no matter what. If they're not happy with it, maybe the diehard Tolkien fans would continue watching it even if they're hating it, but... About Lord of the Rings? Is that what you're working on, Michelle? Is that why you're working overtime? September 2nd, 2022. You guys clearly know your Tolkien better than I do. I've read Lord of the Rings, and I read Hobbit, but... most of what I remember, I only remember from the movie. Of course, Michelle, you're a huge Lord of the Rings fan, so that's maybe why you know it. Maybe has more to do with that than whatever project you may or may not be working on. Okay. Well, that's pretty cool anyway. So, okay, scale of 1 to 10 though, Michelle. Even if you only got to do like a tiniest bit, being the Lord of the Rings fan that you are, scale of 1 to 10, how stoked were you to do like anything on that? Is that like a career highlight so far? Can imagine. Okay. You know what gig I would have loved to have had? And I might have talked about this at the time. I don't remember. But when I watched WandaVision, like when it first started, the animated intro that was like a parody on Bewitched and I Dream of Jeannie, holy shit, would I have loved to do that. And I could have, and like, I could have animated that in like a weekend. But because it's Marvel and Disney, I probably would have gotten paid so well too. But just like to have that on my, like, that would be one hell of a thing to check off my bucket list. Animated intro for a Marvel series. Hey, Parker. What do you mean, how would I do a Tuesday night stream? I haven't watched this week's yet, no. I've actually been rewatching all the Marvel movies. Last weekend I binged like 3 to 4 movies a night. I'm almost through them. Reasonably soon, I'm gonna be back in full workaholic mode. And I thought, you know what? I've been wanting to do the Marvel rewatch for a while. Let's do it right now. I saw last week's. I saw the zombie one. Or no, wait, was there another one after the zombie one? I think it was the zombie one, yeah. Okay, yeah, no, I haven't watched that one yet. Oh, wait, you mean which Marvel movie am I on? I just watched Infinity War. Oh, Infinity War? I like it. I mean, it's not the first time I've rewatched it. I think that, like, I mean, it's not a complete movie, of course, and I think that, but you kind of know that going in, and I've always looked at the Marvel movies as more like a TV show where the episodes just happen to be like 2 hours long and focus on different characters. So like with that in mind, you treat it like part one of the season finale. I think it works pretty well. Why did it not hold up as well on your rewatch, Parker? Okay, gotcha. Yeah, no, I think it's a pretty impressive feat. And it's cool watching them all so close to one another as well, because it's been pretty long since I'd seen some of them. And I'd seen each one at least twice before, because I saw each one in theaters and I own each one, so I would always watch it at least once when I first bought it. But I think especially I think all the Phase 1 movies I'd seen a few times, because there wasn't that many of them at the time, so doing a rewatch wasn't a big deal, and I would be like, okay, I'm gonna rewatch the first 5 standalones before I watch Avengers and things like that. But then as it got deeper into it, it was like harder to do that because there were just too many movies to be rewatching and stuff. Very much so, Billy. I think even the worst Marvel movie is pretty entertaining. I think the Thor the Dark World is probably the weakest, and the villain is the biggest reason for that, but even at that, I don't hate the movie. There was a time when I actually would have said that Iron Man 2 was maybe the weakest, but on my rewatch, I don't feel that way anymore. I think it's the weakest of the Iron Man movies, in my opinion. And part of it definitely, like, Tony's arc isn't badly done, but it's a bit of a rehash of the first one. And, yeah, I think that might be true of it, because it spends a bit too much time setting up Avengers and whatnot. But that first Iron Man, I think, still holds up extremely well. I think it is still one of my favorite of the whole series. I think part of it is that it's a more unique origin story than a lot of them have, you know? It's not about avenging a dead parent or something. It's about kind of redeeming himself because he realized he wasn't a good guy and he was doing some bad shit. Yeah, but I think, I mean, it still did really well. I don't think that really hurt it much. Yeah, I agree. Does that mean you're not an Iron Man fan, Mars? Yeah, that's all because of legal issues. That there hasn't been another Hulk movie. I think if the Edward Norton movie had been a bigger financial success, I think they would have worked out a deal to do more with Universal. But it maybe didn't seem viable after that movie didn't do that well. But I think the only reason it didn't do that well is like Marvel wasn't like a brand yet. And the average person's association with Hulk was the Ang Lee movie, and a lot of people didn't like that. There is some stories you could do with them, I think. He's a douche, Mars, in that he's still the kind of snarky and stuff, but, like, he has a pretty strong arc over the course of the whole series, I think. Same thing with Cap. They kind of, like, reverse roles a little bit. That playlist just ended, if you're wondering why I got up. Yeah. I never watched the Avengers show. Although he kind of almost does in the first Avengers. Like, he survives, but he's willing to sacrifice himself in there, in that one. I like Thor Ragnarok a lot. But I kind of wish Planet Hulk got its whole movie. They're doing a She-Hulk series, which I'm pretty excited about. I haven't read much She-Hulk, but I've always liked the character. And she's a really popular character as well. And apparently, Mark Ruffalo is going to appear in it. But I'm not sure to what capacity. Also, something I'm kind of interested in, I'm curious about. Exactly, Mars. Yeah, exactly. That's what I meant with the Planet Hulk thing. I don't think they're going to slut shame her. Why, what makes you say that, Chantel? Okay, I get what you mean. I don't think they'll... I don't think they would do that. Hope they're smarter than that. Here's my what I'm curious about with it. I started to say earlier and I didn't finish. So, She-Hulk's origin story is she's Bruce Banner's cousin. And then something happens. Can't remember if it's an accident or if it's a disease or whatever. But then Banner gives her a blood transfusion. And that's what turns her into She-Hulk. And she retains her intelligence when she's in Hulk mode. And she can transform at will and stuff like that. But in The Incredible Hulk, the Edward Norton one, which is canon, they established that his blood is toxic and it would kill you. So I'm curious if they'll change the storyline or if they'll address that in some way or if they're just going to kind of create a plot hole or what. I think she does, Mars, yeah. Whether or not she's willing to show, though, I don't know. She's a lawyer in the comics. I think it'd be cool. You could kind of do this almost like procedural type thing with her. Roth got a synthesized version of the Super Soldier Serum, like their attempt to recreate it. Got multiple injections, some of them put in the wrong spot. And so that started to, made him super strong, but started to fuck with his head and stuff. And started to do some weird stuff with his bone structure and whatnot. And then he gets the doctor that was trying to cure Banner to use Banner's blood in some way to do something to him. So actually, yeah, you're right. You might be onto something there. And it's the mixture of the two serums that that does it. I don't know if it was, but... he's basically confirmed he's in it, so it probably is, Mars. I still need to watch season 3 of, I loved... the first two seasons of Daredevil. But when season 3 came out, I was busy working on something and I was like, gonna wait until I'm done this project before I watch the show. And then they announced that it was done, it was canceled, and they kind of took the wind out of my sails a little bit. Because I was worried, it was like, well, are you gonna set me up for something that's not gonna be finished now? I don't know how I feel about this. True. I think Marvel themselves, their trailers haven't been too bad as far as spoilers, but the exception would be Spider-Man, but I think that's more Sony's doing than Marvel themselves. Like the one I always think of when we're talking about bad trailers that give away too much is Homecoming. I think they did announce he's actually going to come back in another show, actually, but I forget which one. What I'm curious about is if they establish... Okay, so, like, the Netflix shows were intended to be in the same universe as the movies to begin with. But then they didn't really, like, do anything with that, and I don't know if they still consider them canon or not. So if Murdock and Spider-Man kind of reestablishes that they are, I wonder if they'll do a season 4, but do it on Disney Plus or something. But if so, is it still going to be as dark as it is, or are they going to lighten it up? As in the stove was on? Yikes. How long were they on there? Are they like black balloons now? So you have Mr. Tortillas on the stove. Air in them expands and just gets ridiculous. But they usually expand out, right? Like, they're ridiculous when you do that. What color? They turn black or they turn an unexpected color? Yeah. See, the vibe I always got, because those were made without any involvement by Feige. So the vibe I always got was that the shows did their best to stay in line with the movies, but the movies never made any effort to stay in line with the shows. But even if that was the intent, the shows, I don't think, ever did anything to expressly contradict the movie. So they could be like, okay, they're canon now, because moving forward, we can control them better. Charcoal black. Yeah, that's what I expected. Yeah, me too. I never did watch that, though. Also, Cloak and Dagger as well. I think it's on Netflix. To be done drawing the skirt of hers. Netflix was only Daredevil, Jessica Jones, Luke Cage, and Iron Fist. And I'm behind on all of them. I loved the first season of Jessica Jones. Like almost as much as Daredevil, but I wasn't nearly as into the second season. Yeah, definitely a big part of it, because Tenet was great. But also, though, like, because even in the first season, much as I did love it, I think a big part of what I love, like, I'm a sucker for detective stories and film noir stuff. I don't know why the video is so much darker today. It's so weird. But anyway, that first season felt very noirish. And it was all about the mystery. But when we get down to that last handful of episodes, it got into more superhero territory. And I like superhero stuff, obviously. That's why I'm watching the show also. But I really dug that very different vibe that they had going. And it was disappointing to see it go. And I don't think it really came back in season two. But I do have season three on my list. It's been on there for a while. next? I gotta. Skirt should be more up there because of the way I've got it flaring back here. Yeah, exactly. Never get the rest of her hand here. The camera. Cause that's what I do. By the way, guys, might have noticed my post, but my Kickstarter is going to go live next week for Combat Fairies to get print copies made. So if anybody wants to read Combat Fairies in print, you'll have the opportunity And there's other stuff on there as well. No obligation from anybody, obviously. I was actually hoping to go live yesterday, which, if you remember me commenting on Tuesday that the I might have something a little bit different with the streams coming up next week. That was why I wasn't able to go go live yet this week, because I wasn't accounting for like an approval process and stuff. It's now been approved, but I thought I'd give it a week to promote it and stuff. The complete graphic novel, which is almost 300 pages, isn't as cheap as I would like it to be, because I had to account for the 5% that Kickstarter takes and stuff. So it's going to be like 45. But it'll also, because of that, I'm also throwing in other stuff. So it'll have a sticker, a bookmark, a digital coloring book, a digital behind the scenes art book, mobile backgrounds, and I'm forgetting something. Oh, PDF of the original script, if anyone was interested in that as well. But for anybody who's interested, but that's too rich for their blood, there is cheaper options on there as well. I was relieved I didn't have to charge more, to be honest. $45 isn't actually that bad by graphic novel standards, considering how thick it is, but it's also like, I'm not a known commodity. All right, well, that's a relief to hear that, Billy. I paid $50 for the Long Halloween. But that's Batman. Thanks, Parker. I will sign all copies. Yes. Also, if you buy through the Kickstarter, I'm going to throw your name in the special thanks at the back. All the backers. So I'll be promoting that like crazy. It's going to go live next Wednesday. But then the following weekend and through the week, I'm going to do a whole stream-a-thon where I'm going to do a bunch of combat fairy stuff on the stream. I'm going to draw the cover on the stream. I'll also color it on the stream, digital color, for be the first time I did that. And I'm going to, one of the other incentive prizes on the Kickstarter is going to be a different posters for each character. So I'm going to do all those live on the stream as well. And then color them all in the final. So there's going to be like an 8-day streamathon. I think it's going to be. Or no, wait. Yeah, 8-day streamathon. But that'll be starting next Saturday is the plan. So the streams next week will be normal. But then the week after that, it's going to be all combat fairies. Thank you. I've actually done quite a few of these multi-armed women lately. The first year I did Mermaid. I did the drummer mermaid with extra arms. And the most recent mermaid I did one, I think, with extra arms as well. I think the holistic one. And I did that cyborg, cyberpunk girl that had the extra arms. I think there was another one recently, too. I'm forgetting who that was. Right. Thanks, Chantel. Almost there, folks. Just gotta finish off her hair. right. I thought you were making a joke there at first, Mars. Okay, see you tomorrow. Thanks. think spot blacks, and then it's done. That's what I think. I will be coloring it, but not right now. I'm gonna color it over the weekend. Let's see if I missed anything. My sleep. I got a 9 a.m. class tomorrow too. That's why Mars left, because she's in the class. Okay, so that's it for me, guys. I'm gonna be. Oh wait, I haven't signed it yet. One sec. Holdo stoppo. That's what my dad says a lot of times. I don't know where he got that from. There we go. Thanks, Billy. This is true, Parker. Anyway, okay. So, I think it's because when I was setting up the camera, I had the lights off in here, so it didn't, like, auto-set the right way. I don't know. I've made that mistake before. I think that's why the image is so dark tonight, but whatever. Good night, Mark. But anyway, yeah, so next Tuesday, I'm going to do another fan art one off the list. It's going to be probably a longer one. It's a mashup that was suggested. It came up in conversation actually, with a friend a while ago, just on Messenger. What started as a joke turned into something that sounded actually really cool. So I'm gonna do that. And it might be somewhat on the epic-ish side. Hopefully we're not talking Batman Double Nighter type scenario, but it will be a longer one probably. And that's true. It's an allergy thing, Parker. It happens to me pretty regularly, around this time of year. And it probably doesn't seem like it to you, but it actually is getting better. I aggravate it when I'm talking a lot. Like, over the weekend, I barely coughed at all. And then today, I had a lecture in the morning and doing this and everything like that. But yeah, it was a couple weeks ago on a patio. I breathed in I'm assuming this is it. Timing lines up and it's happened before, but I breathed in like a bunch of cottonwood. And it was later that day is when I first started feeling it. And that always gets to me. So I think that's what it is. I have an inhaler and stuff as well. It's a fairly common thing for me. It's just frustrating right now because I know how people look at anybody with a cough right now. But anyway, yeah, you mentioned that before, Chantel. That's definitely possible as well. But anyway, I'll be back next week. And thanks for watching, everybody, as usual. And have a good night. See you next time.